हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू youtube.com/डॉक्टर चैनल। आई एम डॉक्टर पी आर पटेल, प्रोफेसर इन वेटरनरी मेडिसिन। हियर वी विल डिस्कस डर्मेटोफिलोसिस पार्ट टू, पैथोजेनेसिस इन डिटेल ऑफ इम्पोर्टेंट बैक्टीरियल डिजीज ऑफ डोमेस्टिक एनिमल्स। We discuss here important part, pathogenesis of dermatophilosis. The important factor for the establishment of dermatophilosis infection is reduction in normal protective barrier of epidermis of skin. When reduction in normal protective barrier epidermis of the skin goes down or deficient, the infection enter and infection establishes. And the skin surface become susceptible to motile juice spores of the dermatophilus. The juice spores enter into the epidermis, germinate and produce hyphae. We already know that. These hyphae invade hair follicle, sweat gland and other epidermis layers. Continue with the pathogenesis. The Dermatophilus congolensis organism has certain weapons to penetrate and establish infection. These organisms are highly proteolytic, lysis of protein, and they liberate urease. They increase hydrolyzing casein, they liquefy gelatin and coagulate serum. All these weapons help in establishment and spread of the infection into the body. There is a penetration of hyphae into the living epidermis, and slowly the hyphae spread in all directions, and slowly the lesion increases in size in a concentric way. Continue with the pathogenesis. When hyphae or juice spores enter into the body, they initiate acute inflammatory reaction at the site of penetration and at the site of lesion. We already know that moisture, high humidity, high temperature, heavy rainfall, this facilitates release of juice spore from the skin lesions. Juice spores are motile. Juice spores penetrate into the epidermis and it creates a new foci of infection, and it further spread infection to the other part of the skin and other part of the body. Continue with the pathogenesis. When there is acute infection, the filamentous invasion of epidermis stops or ceases in 2 to 3 weeks because there is acute inflammatory reaction. The phagocytosis and other immunity is working. Then the lesion heals spontaneously, spontaneous recovery. In chronic infection, the infected hair follicle and scabs intermittently and constantly shed the infection of Dermatophilus. Continuation of pathogenesis, liberation of juice spores from one lesion, and they motile move ahead and they invade the non-infected hair follicle and epidermis and establish new infection. Thus it spreads. There is a cornification of the invaded epithelium. Characteristic find, cornification of the epithelium. Separation in the form of scab. There is exudation, scab formation, and slowly there is scab separate from the body. When scab become wet or moisture condition, again there is proliferation of this dermophilus congolensis and release of motile juice spores from the hype, and again spread of the infection and establish new foci of infection. Continue with the pathogenesis. Juice spore being motile, they swarm from the existing lesions, go to the other places, create a new lesion, or they may enlarge the existing lesions in a concentric way, and thus the lesion enlarges on the skin. Continue with pathogenesis. When there are plenty of juice spores, so there is dense population of juice spores at one place, and these juice spores causes high concentration of carbon dioxide in the skin. When carbon dioxide in the skin increases, these motile juice spores escape from the original lesion and they come up on the surface of the skin. This is how the organism completes a unique life cycle. This organism has unique life cycle. High P spores like this. So they have a unique life cycle. To summarize the development of lesions, there are three stages. First stage, second stage, third stage. In the first stage, the hairs of the infected animals remain erect. Infection is there, but hairs remain erect. But these hairs are matted, joined with the exudate, and they form a thick crust. The hairs adhere strictly to each other and they form a tuft, and hairs are difficult to remove. This is the characteristic of the dermatophilosis for the diagnosis. Such lesion is called as paintbrush lesion, because in the paintbrush also all hairs are joined together. Here the all hairs are joined together with the exudate. So such lesion is called as paintbrush lesion. This is the important lesion cattle. Second stage of the lesion, as the disease progress, there is thick greasy scab and crust formation, characteristic of the disease. Then there is formation of fissures on the dry scales, and these fissures are painful. It may invite a secondary bacterial infection also. The disease progresses to third stage. The scales turn very hard. They become horny like tissue, hard, and they join together, confluent, making the large scars or hard scab. Then there is marked alopecia. When the cases are very mild, they heal spontaneously. Otherwise, disease progresses to further secondary bacterial infection. Friends, Here I have narrated different stages of disease, pathogenesis at different stages, what will happen, how the disease spreads, when there is exudation, when there is matting of the hair and wounds, when there is scab formation, fortification, healing, etc. Please share this important information to student friends and veterinary friends. To promote the channel, subscribe the channel. Thank you very much for observing video.